Fibrocystic changes of the breast is a very common problem. And I'm often asked, gee, Dr. Harness, does having fibrocystic changes of the breast cause breast cancer? Well, not directly, certainly, that I know of. Now, I need to define somewhat fibro and cystic changes of the breast. Fibro, meaning scarring, if you will, and cysts, fluid-filled sacs, if you will, within the breast. Now, of those fluid-filled sacs in the breast called cysts, there are different kinds of cysts. The most common kind is called a simple cyst, probably caused by an obstruction of a duct. There's a buildup of fluid. We can see these easily with ultrasound. And as long as there's no structure inside the cyst, it's called a simple cyst. And there is no worry that that simple cyst will go on to develop breast cancer. Now, with everything I do in the world of breasts and breast cancer, are there exceptions to what I just said? Well, not with simple cysts, but there can be with things called complex cysts. In other words, if there are little walls between the cysts or the edges of the cyst don't look real smooth on ultrasound, these are called complex cysts, and often the best way of finding out what's going on with them is with an ultrasound-guided core biopsy. Well, let me take this now one step further. There can be things that can grow inside a cyst called intra, the word intra means within, intracystic lesions. And there are benign intracystic lesions called intracystic papillomas. Again, we would do a biopsy of these to determine whether they're cancerous or not. Any question at all, we would do an excisional biopsy, take the entire cyst out, that lesion, and look at it under the microscope. There is, in fact, a rare form of breast cancer called intracystic papillary cancer that indeed is like an in situ type of breast cancer. And that category of complex cysts with a lesion inside does need to be treated like other forms of in situ breast cancer. Now, the one other difficulty with fibrocystic changes of the breast is the fact that the breasts are dense, and we do know that mammograms are less sensitive with more density in the breast. And there's also literature to suggest that really increased density of the breast is an increased risk factor for breast cancer. So with women who have really dense breasts, part of the screening process likely should also include an ultrasound examination of the breast. And then there's a multitude of other things that would go into calculating whether even additional technologies would be needed in specific cases of breast density. That's the subject of another video at another time, but the bottom line of this video is simple cysts do not become breast cancer. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.